I got into a debt of 60 lakhs. We became a big laughing stock in the society. We were searching for food for the next 2 years. We had nothing to eat at home. We decided to commit suicide. So then, thoda sa positive shuru hua. All the 2 years of our bamboo work was featured by World Bank in their project. We had all the global universities, starting from Harvard, Stanford, Kellogg, Cornell, and ISB, doing a case study on our business model. How many of you would go to a risky border of the country immediately after marriage to buy a sofa set? I did. You also did? Okay. Not before, not after marriage, I hope. Okay. Fine. Hi. My name is Prashant. I'm the co-founder of a social enterprise named Bamboo House India. We build houses with bamboo. So for the next 15 minutes, I'll take you through my bamboo journey. For this, you will have to travel back in time with me. So this was the year 2006. So this was the third month of our marriage. So my wife Aruna, she's the co-founder of the enterprise. So she came to me and said, Prashant, chalo, sofa set kharidte. Mujhe shopping nahi jana tha. But new wife, you can't say no. You can't take the chance. So I said, okay, chalo, chalte hain. So we went across the city of Hyderabad searching for an eco-friendly sofa set. We didn't find anything to our liking. We came back, we Googled up, and Google gave us some interesting results. We came to know something called bamboo furniture. So searching for a bamboo furniture, we landed up in a small village called Katlamara on the Indo-Bangladesh international border to buy a bamboo sofa set. Sounds crazy, right? So that's what happens if you get married. Don't laugh at me. So all married people are a part of me today. Okay, so next. So when we entered the village, we noticed that the entire village was with lush green bamboo fields. And all the village communities were making small bamboo handicrafts. We immediately got connected. You can say it's something like falling in love. You don't know why. Ho gaya bas. So there we decided, let's make bamboo houses. Very weird. Kyunki Google mein dekha tha, apart from bamboo furniture, there are so many things what can be used, you know, bamboo can be used. Humne socha bamboo ka house banate hain. Let's work with the communities. Let's help them out because they are not making a decent living. We came back, we shared the idea with the family. I come from a very typical middle class Telugu family. All this nonsense is not allowed. Bhai chup-chap kaam karo, hume maaf karo. So we said, no, it's an interesting idea. We will go ahead. So fourth month of the marriage, we did something very weird, me and my wife. We traveled across all the forest locations of the country. We stayed there for 1 year. All the relatives were of the opinion, honeymoon manane gaye. We went for a study tour across all the forest locations of the country. We came back from the study tour after 12 months. We started Bamboo House India. Ghar banana tha. So fine, that's where the whole thing started. Then, life started rolling back. In all the excitement of starting up, building bamboo houses, working with communities, living in forest, we forgot the most important thing. There was something called Indian Forest Act 1927. The act says you cannot go to forest and cut bamboo and bring to the city without the written permission of the government. So that was a bouncer. Ek saal kya kar rahe the, pata nahi, jhak maar rahe the. To kya kare? We thought, okay, it's a challenge, let's face it, let's go ahead. Then, another hurdle. We survived a bomb blast to one of the visits in one part of the country is this distance. We closely survived a bomb blast. Luckily, bach gaye. So there was a huge pressure from the family for us to withdraw. But we refused to withdraw. Then, another incident. So I was picked up twice. It's not because I look like this. I was in a non-local area where it is supposed to be risky for non-locals to go. I was in captivity for the whole night. So they let me out day in the morning. My wife was all happy, chalo jaan chuti. So that wrecked me emotionally. Because wo aapko chhodenge subah, nahi chhodenge pata nahi. They can either leave me, they can either harm me, they can either kill me. I had no idea. So by that time, family said, enough is enough. Bahut ho gaya, band karo. But we said, no, we are going ahead. We decided to go ahead and continue our journey. So in all these adventures, experiments, we killed 3 years. So any guesses what might have happened after 3 years? I got into a debt of 60 lakhs. Because I had no idea about what I was doing, I burnt money left, right and center. We became a big laughing stock in the society. I have awesome relatives, huh? Please. So, kuch nahi pata tha kya kar rahe. Nobody was accepting of our idea of bamboo houses. Everybody was rejecting it. But we kept our journey. But things didn't stop there. Life picked up so good, it decided isko to chhodna nahi hai. So the next incident, major incident, during that time, I broke my leg. I have a rod here. So I was bedridden for 1.5 years. So at the same time, my wife delivered her first kid and she developed uterus infection. So it became a cancerous kind of a situation. So she was also bedridden for 1.5 years. So any guesses kya hota hai jab aapke upar 60 lakh ka karza hai? आपका आइडिया कोई खरीद नहीं रहा है. Nobody is taking your idea and you're bedridden. Any guesses what happens? No, we were searching for food for the next 2 years. We had nothing to eat at home. We used to eat only in the afternoons. ताकि सुबह का भूख और रात का भूख खत्म हो जाए. And जो भी 10-20 रुपए होते थे, we had to keep it for our kids' milk. जितने से पैसा उठाना था उठा लिया, कोई देने के लिए था नहीं. And किस मुँह से मांगते? Because everybody was telling this is not going to work out. But we continued. So zindagi ne thaan li thi ki iski leni hai. To chhod nahi raha tha zindagi. So during this phase, I lost my father. He was a diabetic patient, so it was a natural death. I lost my father-in-law. And we lost around 6 loved ones during this phase who were our support pillars. Dekhiye, when you are starting up your own venture is a very risky thing. It's not easy. And we sunk into depression. We decided to commit suicide. Because 60 lakhs, nobody buying. We decided this is not an idea. We went on a wrong path. We chose a wrong path. The only thing which was stopping us from committing suicide was we had a small kid. Na bachche ko chhod sakte, na bachche ko maar sakte. So then one night, we all gathered, me, my mother and my wife. They said, okay, let us do it. But let us give one last chance. Aise bhi marna hai, toh ek bar koshish kar lete hain. So we pulled up all the jewelry in the house, which was kept for daily food and medical emergencies. Thoda thoda bechte the har roj khane ke liye. So we got 60,000 rupees. So coincidentally with that 60,000 rupees, we got our first break. We built our first bamboo house. Any guesses what happened after building our first bamboo house? For the next 2 years, we built 150 bamboo houses. So finally, all our patience and perseverance finally paid off. All our projects were everywhere, literally. And during this time, we received tremendous support from the media. We were literally covered from BBC to local channel. All our work was splashed every day in the paper. We used to see ourselves in the paper every day morning. Then all my relatives again became my relatives. Sare rishtedar mere fir rishtedar ban gaye. Sare dost fir se rishtedar, fir se dost ban gaye. So then, thoda sa positive shuru hua. So I would like to share. When we were struggling, when we were starting up, we went to all the engineering colleges in the country, asking them to help us. देखिए हमें पता नहीं है बैम्बू के बारे में, थोड़ा बहुत मदद कर दीजिए, बिकॉज यू हैव द नॉलेज इन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, बट दे डिडंट बिलीव इन द कॉन्सेप्ट. ठीक है भाई, इट्स ओके, मेरा आइडिया है तो ज़रूरत नहीं है आपको अच्छा लगे. देन समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग हैपन. ऑल द 2 years ऑफ आर बैम्बू वर्क वॉज फीचर्ड बाई वर्ल्ड बैंक इन देयर प्रोजेक्ट. पूरा हमारा जो भी बैम्बू का काम था, दैट वॉज फीचर्ड. देन वन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग हैपन. When we were struggling, we went to all the B schools in the country, asking them to help us in our business modeling. Because हमें कुछ पता नहीं था उसके बारे में. But they were not interested because they didn't see that this was a model at all. Then, after that, something interesting. We had all the global universities, starting from Harvard, Stanford, Kellogg, Cornell, and ISB, doing a case study on our business model. And if I remember, this was the year 2013-14, if I am not wrong. Another important milestone of our journey, which I would like to share. We received an invitation from the US government for our work. My co-founder Aruna, he got an opportunity to visit the White House and meet with the social innovation team of President Obama, share our work, take inputs for growth. That's 2013. And 2015, another important year for us. We started another social enterprise called Recycle India, where the focus was to recycle all the waste that we started. It, we did a lot of work. 2017, another important milestone, for after seeing so many failures, we received an invitation from government of Kenya to build bamboo houses in their country. So the project is going on. 2018, the long journey. I'm standing here in front of you. This was also an important milestone for our work. This year, we constructed 2 houses completely with plastic waste in Hyderabad, which is each plastic waste consumes around 5,000 kgs. What we were doing for the last 3 years, we finally built this year. So it's consumed, it's completely made out of plastic waste. So as a substitute to bamboo houses, we are doing plastic waste houses also. So what I would like to, you know, share with all of you, and most important thing I want to share, is in all these rough patches of my journey, Facebook especially has been extremely instrumental in our business growth. Because as you know, as a small business, as a small social enterprise, in a concept we are trying to spread it out, it's not easy for us. We don't have that kind of a bandwidth to go on a mass media. And you'd be surprised to believe, last year, out of the 2 crores turnover we did, 1 crore worth of orders we got through Facebook. Especially 2 projects, it was a huge project. So, apart from media, social media, Facebook has been instrumental. We still use them as a major tool. So what I would like to conclude my session with, starting up or doing something what you want is definitely not easy. It's going to be extremely harsh. All it requires is tremendous amount of patience and perseverance. So whatever you do, it's not going to be easy. So what I would suggest you is hold on. Your time will definitely come. It's a kind of a seesaw. Achha din bhi nahi rahega to bura din bhi nahi rahega. So at least if you try something tomorrow, you don't have to regret. Failure is always better than regretting. So please keep failing. Don't get into peer pressure. Don't listen to anybody. Let everybody go to hell. Your idea, because your life. So keep trying, keep failing. And one last important thing I would like to share with all of you. Never go to shopping with your wife. Thank you.
Click the subscribe button and press the bell icon to never miss a video from Juice Talks.